Let the hearts that seek the Lord rejoice, turn to the Lord in his strength, constantly seek his face. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, and what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord,
Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, increase our faith, hope, and charity, and make us love what you command, so that we may merit what you promise. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of Exodus. Thus says the Lord, you shall not molest or oppress an alien. For when you were once an alien yourselves in the land of Egypt, you shall not wrong any widow or orphan. If ever you wrong them and they cry out to me, I will surely hear them. My wrath will flare up, and I will kill you with my sword. And then your own wives will be widows, and your children orphans. If you lend money to one of your poor neighbors among my people, you shall not act like an extortionist towards him by demanding interest from him. If you take your neighbor's cloak as a pledge, you shall return it to him by sunset, for this cloak is the only covering he has for his body. What else has he to sleep in? If he cries out to me, I will hear him, for I am compassionate. The word of the Lord.
Everlasting life. perfect, restoring my soul. The Lord's rule is to be trusted, teaching us wisdom. Lord, your words are everlasting life, everlasting life. God's word is true, it gladdens my heart. The Lord's law is clear, it opens my eyes. Lord, your words are everlasting life, everlasting life.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Brothers and sisters, you know what sort of people we are among you for your sake, and you become imitators of us and of the Lord, receiving the word in great affliction with joy from the Holy Spirit, so that you may become a model for all believers in Macedonia and Achaia. For from you the word of the Lord is sounded forth, not only in Macedonia and in Achaia, but in every place your faith in God has gone forth, so that we may have no need to say anything. For they themselves openly declare among us what sort of reception we had among you, and how you turned to God from idols, and to serve the living God and true God, and to await his Son from heaven, whom he raised from the dead, Jesus, who delivers us from the coming wrath. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When the Pharisees heard that Jesus had silenced the Sadducees, they gathered together, and one of them, a scholar of the law, tested him by asking, "Teacher, which commandment in the law is the greatest?" He said to him, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind. This is the greatest and the first commandment. The second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. The whole law and the prophets depend on these two commandments." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord.
A visionary miracle influenced a 4th century Hungarian officer who later became the Bishop of Tours. St. Martin of Tours, as he generally is referred to and is remembered, and I would encourage you to read up on his life, was leading his troops when one day he came upon a very poorly clad beggar suffering in the cold and frigid temperatures. Moved by this man's suffering, St. Martin took off his elegant military cloak, cut it in half, and put it on the beggar. As he was about to go upon his way with his troops, he was stopped by an amazing sight. The beggar was Jesus Christ himself, searching among people for evidence of charity, which he had said was the greatest virtue. Soon after the incident, St. Martin resigned from his military position and in turn became a monk. He founded a monastic community and became known for his healing miracles and his charity, his good deeds to the poor. St. Martin of Tours showed a lesson in charitable love, which makes evident that he loved the Lord God wholeheartedly, and he loved his neighbor as himself. In paragraph 2392 of the Catechism of the Catholic Church, it teaches us that, and I quote, "Love is the fundamental and innate vocation of every human being," end quote. Each one of us who has been created in the image and likeness of God are called to strive to love the way Jesus Christ loves, that is, unconditionally. Of course, it's difficult for us to do because we're not perfect like Christ, but we're called to do so and to try with all of our efforts. Our priorities indicate how things are relative in importance to each of us. If we have only so much time in the evening, maybe when we come home from work, we probably make dinner, and if we have children, help them with their homework, and maybe help clean up after dinner, make some phone calls that we've been putting off, before we kick off our shoes and sit back and relax, and maybe watch television or read. Studying is an important thing that takes priority over going out with our friends if we have an upcoming exam. Taking time to exercise daily also indicates that we care about our physical health, which, you know, if you know me and see me, you know that physical exercise is on my low priority of things to do. But the things that are important to us generally have an impact upon our life, upon our well-being, and of course that of others. This Sunday's Gospel from St. Matthew is about priorities. And it indicates to us what is to be the top priority for all of us, as Jesus very clearly said, and I quote, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind." And he continued, "You shall love your neighbor as yourself," end quote. We heard in today's first reading from the book of Exodus, which details what love of neighbor requires. We are not to abuse, neglect, or oppress any strangers or widows or orphans. Now that phrase, the phrases strangers and aliens and orphans and widows, identify three categories of needy people in Israel at the time of the Old Testament, and therefore can stand as a metaphor today for us to refer to anyone who is in most need. We recall in the gospel that the scholar of the law, he tests Jesus by asking him to prioritize, to identify the greatest law. Now, had Jesus answered by naming as most important one of the numerous precepts so dear to the Pharisees, so dear to them that they insisted that they be kept meticulously, well, Christ would have failed the test. Jesus does indeed state a clear priority with his answer. There is one commandment above all the others, to love God with our entire being. That is the most important thing in each of our lives, and everything we do will probably be measured against our love of God. Love God wholeheartedly and love your neighbor as yourself is how Jesus sums up the whole of the law and the prophets in the Old Testament. These vertical and horizontal loves are clearly visible in the beams of the cross on which Christ was crucified, which binds all creation together and, of course, leads all creation to God our Heavenly Father. Remember, which probably most of us don't because we were little babies, that we each receive the sign of the cross on our foreheads when we receive the sacrament of baptism. It's signed first by the priest or the deacon, and then in the rite of baptism, the parents and godparents are invited to do the same. It's a sign that we are servants of the living God, who raised his son Jesus Christ from the dead, so that Christ might save us from sin and death. So the challenge today is, do we each bear our baptismal cross before our brothers and sisters in need, our neighbor, and before God our Father? Jesus continues to educate us that the second commandment, loving your neighbor as yourself, is a rephrasing of the first in terms of human beings, our brothers and sisters, with whom we live and relate to every day of our lives, some of which we may never encounter. Some may live clear across the oceans, away from us. Here is the surprise. Love of God and love of neighbor really aren't separated. For in loving our neighbor, we love God. We cannot separate love of God and love of neighbor because our neighbor is created in the image and likeness of God and bears within himself or herself the presence of God. Love and charity is something that is meant to be shared, not selfishly kept to oneself. Furthermore, our love of God cannot be something that we only think of, only a thought, or only something that we say. Our love of God and our love of neighbor must be carried out by loving actions toward our neighbor. This is how God has already loved us and acted toward us. Just gaze upon a crucifix to see how much God truly loved the world. Moreover, in a few moments from this very sacred altar, in the holy sacrifice of the Mass, we will each receive that true gift of love, the body, blood, soul, and divinity of our Lord Jesus Christ. May the sanctifying grace of this sacrament transform each of us into the likeness of Jesus Christ. We know that Election Day is coming in, I don't know how many days, I'm not keeping track, but it's very rapidly approaching us. We as Catholics, as Christians, have a moral duty to have well-informed consciences. We're called to do that. We need to form our conscience in the teachings of the Church on issues dealing with the dignity and right of human life, the dignity of marriage and family. Some of those issues are abortion and human cloning, euthanasia, unethical stem cell research, the dignity of marriage as defined by God as between one man and one woman. We need to take time before we go in to exercise our civil duty to vote and pray. Pray and with a well-formed conscience on all the Church's teachings and her stance on different issues, and then exercise our civil duty to vote. So I would encourage you, there are on the Diocese of Erie website, there are some helpful
I just drew a blank. They're helpful things. So you can go on the diocesan website and look up those things to help you before you go and vote on election day. But remember that the top priority is the dignity of all human life. So pray, form your conscience, and then go and exercise your duty to vote. Praise be Jesus Christ, now and forever.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. As servants of the living God, our Savior, our rock, our mighty help, let us turn to him in humble prayer.
Please respond, Lord, hear our prayer. That through the Church's announcement of the gospel, Christ's saving mission will reach to all the ends of the earth. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That civil leaders will use their authority to protect and provide for the poor, the oppressed, the unborn. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our parish will grow in devotion and love for the Holy Eucharist, and be filled with the charity and compassion for Jesus Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the increase of vocations into the priesthood and to the consecrated life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the safety of those in the military, for police officers, firefighters, and all first responders, may they be protected by St. Michael the Archangel. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick may be comforted and healed, and that those who have died may share the joys of heaven. We pray especially for Joseph Dolachik, for whom this Mass is being offered, and for William Brittenbaugh Jr. and Bernice Strahler, mother of Thomas Strahler, who died this past week. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Please pause now to add your own personal intentions. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, grant our prayers as we strive to love you as we love one another, taught by your only begotten Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Look, we pray, O Lord, on the offerings we make to your majesty, that whatever is done by us in your service may be directed above all to your glory. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For when your children were scattered afar by sin, through the blood of your Son and the power of the Spirit, you gather them again to yourself, that a people formed as one by the unity of the Trinity, made the body of Christ and the temple of the Holy Spirit, might, to the praise of your manifold wisdom, be manifest as the church. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim.
Blessed is he who comes
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dew fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Lawrence, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, amen, amen. Amen, amen, amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. You will ring out our joy at the saving help and exalt in the name of our God. Thank you. Let us pray. May your sacraments, O Lord, we pray, perfect in us what lies within them, and what we now celebrate in signs, we may one day possess in truth, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to
God. Offer the prayer in time of pandemic. Lord Jesus, you came to bring salvation to our world. You humbled yourself to accept death on a cross. Be with us as we confront the spread of the coronavirus with courage and hope. Be present to the sick and to those who accompany them in their suffering. Strengthen our medical professionals and caregivers. Comfort families who are separated from one another. Protect those who are at risk of the virus in their work. Grant wisdom to our civic officials and perseverance to scientists. Spare us from the ravages of this illness and console us in our uncertainty and fear. Unite us in hope, enlighten us in faith, and give us the grace as a church to love one another as you have loved us. Through the intercession of our Heavenly Mother, Mary, we make this prayer as we place our trust in you. Amen. Have a blessed evening, everyone.